Last year, wildfires destroyed the town of Lahaina, Maui, in one of the deadliest fires in modern U.S. history. The fires affected everything from the drinking supply to the island's fragile coral reefs. Find out what happened on NSF Science now. Almost a year ago, wildfires enveloped the beautiful and picturesque Hawaiian island of Maui, affecting thousands of community members. The fires devastated the city of Lahaina in one of the deadliest fires in modern U.S. history, killing over 100 people.
So the fire spread very quickly. I think it was so fast that it basically overwhelmed Maui County's ability to respond to them. And the fires mainly happened that night and burned the town to the ground. And then continued for several weeks after that in pockets.
The fires burned over 2,170 acres and damaged or destroyed an estimated 2,200 buildings, creating a toxic environment likely to affect water quality and Maui's fragile coral reef ecosystem. Water usage advisories impact residents' access to safe drinking water and access to the waterways and coral ecosystems these grief-stricken communities rely on daily for food. With NSF RAPID Response Research grants for quick response disaster research, two NSF-supported teams from the University of Hawai'i at Mānoa were on the ground immediately following the fires, one to assess the drinking water quality and the other to determine the damage to the coral reef ecosystem surrounding Maui.
Yeah, so the big concern after the wildfires really was runoff of pollutants, debris, ash, you know, anything that can be suspended or dissolved in water into coastal waters, as well as stream waters and groundwater.
The heat of these fires incinerates plastics, vehicles, household chemicals, and water pipes, releasing dangerous contaminants.
And the service lines are often made out of PVC, you know, or have other plastic parts. And when they're exposed to high heat, where they actually burn, or water pipes inside of people's homes, you know, get melted, and then there's open holes where homes are on fire, things can get sucked into the water distribution system, and then they can actually move around the system. So those things that we're worried about.
Following the fires, an unsafe water advisory was put into place in Lahaina.
However, the water distribution systems were affected to some extent from our sampling. And so that's what I've primarily been focused on.
Chris's team is working closely with the community and officials to test the water supply and communicate these findings to the community.
You know, unfortunately, the community doesn't always trust government agencies. And so that's one of the places that we can act as a bridge is, you know, we can share the information that they're sharing. We can validate its authenticity, and we can take our own samples and verify, you know, kind of what they're seeing in the water systems.
Almost a year later, the community is working to get back on its feet.
You know, our program is still really quite relevant and helpful to community members. But yeah, certainly there is progress moving forward on restoring safe water access to the whole island.
Meanwhile, Maui native and University of Hawaii colleague Andrea Kealoha's team focused on Maui's fragile coral ecosystems, which are vital to Maui residents.
The ocean is so critical to the health of our culture. It's a place that we get our food. It's a place that we gather. It's a place that we conduct our cultural activities. And so it's really important that we have a healthy coastal ecosystem, not just for the health of our community and their culture, but also for the perpetuation of our culture.
This is the first time in history that an urban fire has burned right next to a coral reef, threatening its very survival.
So I think wildfires have a surprising impact on waters, perhaps, because as they burn, they change the soil chemistry. It allows water to run off much more easily. So perhaps the biggest visual impact is you see more sediment in the ocean or maybe in streams. And then there's also the invisible impact of waterborne chemicals, which could include harmful pollutants like metals or harmful organic compounds.
It takes a village to save and protect this critical ecosystem from disastrous events.
This work that we're doing is part of a large collaborative effort of people that includes not just the University of Hawaii, but UH Maui College, federal agencies, local agencies, community organizations, individual community members.
Andrea's team placed auto samplers off West Maui to measure carbon dioxide concentrations, along with sensors that measure temperature, salinity, oxygen, and chlorophyll every 5 minutes, monitoring how the reefs are growing or dissolving.
One of the tools that we use in this project is an auto sampler, which is a pretty simple concept. It's just it's a computer that we put down at the bottom of the ocean, and it can pump water into bags for us at different times. So this lets us capture how the chemistry on the reef is changing throughout the day and night cycle.
They were surprised at what they found.
So far, we have measured high levels of copper and zinc for metals, and we're also seeing high concentrations of nutrients in coastal waters.
Now that collection is complete, Andrea's team will spend the summer analyzing hundreds of samples.
Yeah, so we're approaching a one-year anniversary to when the fire happened. And there's still an incredible amount of work that this community has to do to recover from this. This project is a real opportunity to kind of focus people and get everyone together and thinking about how we can better protect these resources from things like wildfires, but also, you know, from all sorts of impacts and stressors that the ocean is facing right now.